Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Firstly, we have a topic that is asset test ratio formula, also known as the liquidity ratio formula. Like just like you have a current ratio, we have liquidity test ratio also. And it is also known as by the name of asset test ratio. So what we try over here to analyze how far the company is liquid in terms of its current liabilities that are standing in front of them. Well, we'll try and understand this in a very detailed format. And the first and the foremost thing that we're going to begin with is the formula, as you can see, the cash plus cash and cash equivalents plus marketable securities and the account receivable. When we add all of these four components, dividing by the current liabilities, we get the asset test ratio formula. Let's begin. See, the formula for the asset test ratio, it is basically a measure of liquidity, which is calculated by dividing the summation of the most liquid assets. Okay, like, you know, I'm talking about here cash and cash equivalents, right? Then we have marketable securities, the short-term investments, and debtors, which is also known as your accounts receivables, right? And this is divided by the total current liabilities. Now, this ratio is also known as your quick ratio. Now, there are a couple of methods by which this can be calculated. Method number one. The formula, basically, mathematically, it represents as, you know, the asset test ratio is equal to, we start with cash plus cash equivalents plus marketable securities, and we add debtors over here, and we divide this whole thing by total current liabilities. We divide by total current liabilities. So, step number one that we'll go with is, you know, first all the liquid assets like cash and cash equivalents, cash, short-term investments, marketable securities, and your current accounts, which can be liquidated within 90 days, okay, are identified from the balance sheet, and they are to be what we call as added up. Step number two. Now, the asset test ratio is computed by dividing the summation of the liquid assets in step number one with the current liabilities. This was the first method by which you can calculate. There is method number two that goes something like this. See, another formula which is more popular or you popularly use to calculate the test ratio is first by deducting the inventory from the total current assets. So it's like your total current assets, and we'll be deducting less your inventory, right? From that we'll deduct the inventory, and then you will divide by the total current liabilities. So either you add up all things or you deduct from the total the inventory straight away. So inventory is excluded in the formula because, you know, it is not considered to be rapidly cash convertible factor. Mathematically, it can be represented something like this. Let me put this in this way. The asset test ratio is equal to your total current assets less inventory divided by the total current liabilities. When you do this, you get your asset test ratio. Over here, the step one will be identify sum of all the current assets and the inventory from the balance sheet needs to be deducted, and the reduction of the inventory from the total current assets. Step number two. Now the asset test ratio is computed by dividing the value in the step number one, divide by the total current liabilities from the balance sheet. So as can be seen from the above, the asset test ratio formula assesses, you know, the liquidity position of an entity by computing how well the most liquid assets can cover the current liability. Let me take a short example to make you understand this. There are some of the examples. We can start with example number one. Let's say there are a couple of details on the current asset side and on the current liability side. I'll put down some numbers and we'll try and figure out those details in a quick fashion. Here we expand. Okay. Now, on the current asset side, we have cash of 2,500. We have accounts receivables standing at 12,500 and inventory standing at 15,000. And on the current liability side, let's say the accounts payable is standing at 12,500. Accrued payables are standing at 1,500. And there is notes payable that is standing at $500. So using the above formula, the asset test ratio of over here, let's say this is ABC company, can be computed as, well, we'll add up some of all this 12,500. We won't add inventory, right? So this will be the numerator, right? And we'll find the denominator, that is the current liabilities. So let's add up accounts payable, accrued payables and notes payable. Let's add all of this three. So the asset test ratio ATR will be 15,000 divided by 14,500. That goes to 1.03. That's a good number. Let's take another example. Example number two. Now, in this scenario, let's say current assets and current liabilities, which are standing. The first, we have cash and cash equivalents, CE. Let's say standing at 25,913. Short-term investments standing at 43,88. And then we have net receivables that is standing at 48,995. And inventory that is, let's say, standing at 3,956. And then there is the other current assets that is standing at 12,087. Let's put down numbers in the current liability side. We first have accounts payable, that is 55,888. Then we have the short term or short and current long term debt. Let's say it is standing at 2,748. And then we have the other current liabilities that is standing at 4,230. Now let's, using the above mentioned, you know, formula, the asset test ratio over here of Apple Inc., you know, let's try and evaluate for the period of 29 September 2018. The asset test ratio ATR will be, over here we'll be adding 25,913, the short-term investments and net receivables, plus we'll be adding the other current assets except the inventories. And over here, accounts payable will be added, 55,888 plus 2,748 plus 4,230. So there we have our answer as 1.09. Right. So now I have discussed the examples so that, you know, you may have a clear idea regarding what is the real, how this formula has been calculated. I'll quickly give you the uses of the asset test ratio formula. See, the understanding of the asset test ratio is very important because it shows the entity's current liabilities and if an entity has adequate level of liquid assets to cover its current liabilities. So then it does not need to liquidate any of its long-term assets to meet any current obligation. Now, this point is the paramount importance since, you know, most businesses rely on the long-term assets to generate additional revenue, right? And on the other hand, you know, a high or the increased trend in the asset test ratio generally means that the entity is having a strong top-line growth and quickly able to convert the receivables into the cash and comfortable in its financial obligation coverage. So that's it for this particular topic.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.